So every time you catch a Pokemon, you get the option of naming it. And everybody at some point or another has made the decision to name that one Grimer they caught Cum. Then you have others using creatively bankrupt and crass names like Doucheclit or Wankspank. Basically, just nothing that creates a unique identity for the captured Pokemon. So let me give everybody watching a proper education on how to give a truly impactful and fulfilling name to your precious Pokies. So what I like to do when naming my Pokemon is using the TAP system, which stands for Type, Appearance, and Pop Culture. These three things are key elements to picking a good name. You can just apply one of these categories in the system to the name, or you can use all three, it's up to you. So for the type category, you want to base the nickname on whatever type your Pokemon is, obviously. If it's a fire type, incorporate something like flames, charcoal, or propane. Simply naming your Moltres or any other fire-type bird Flaming Cock is not going to leave a lasting impression. I personally like to name all of my flying-type Pokemon after famous flying aircraft throughout history, such as Hindenburg, Enola Gay, and the two planes from 9/11. So the next category on the TAP system, Appearance, is also pretty self-explanatory. Whatever you think your Pokemon looks like, then that in itself is a great inspiration for it to name.
This looks like its whole body is made of like breast tissue. Every time I see this fish, I say it looks like a trans fish.
My starter Bulbasaur in Pokemon Fire Red reminded me of all the STDs I'm afflicted with, so I decided to name him Gonorrhea. And that name stuck all the way to the end of the game. My Lapras was a bit simpler. She was a female, and she had a large shell on her back, so I decided to name her Shellpuss. Then I have a look at the Pokemon Probopass, and, well, just look at him. Look at that nose. How can I not associate him with some Jewish guy? So, you know, I just gotta name him Adam Sandler. And now the final category, my favorite category, is Pop Culture. So this is pretty much just taking the names of famous celebrities, actors, or other famous people and forcing mythical video game creatures to adopt their names. For example, some like to say Steve Buscemi looks like a rat. So logically, I'm going to name my Rattata after him. The Pokedex entry for Drifloon states that it's responsible for causing children to go missing, so obviously the right name for this one is John Podesta. Or here's a really good example. See, the other day I actually happened to stumble upon a shiny Stantler in the wild, and after capturing it, I decided to give it the name Shintler. This name sort of combines all three categories of the TAP system because this Pokemon is both 1. A shiny, 2. A Stantler, and 3, I just wanted to make a reference to Schindler's List. I mean, just look at this guy. He looks like he'd probably commit religious genocide. Would you trust him? So yeah, there's my expert system of naming Pokemon. I feel now is the best time in the video to say that I am very lonely. I haven't left my bedroom in several weeks now. And I have a plush doll of Snorlax staring at me every night as I go to sleep. So yeah, there's that. Oh, and by the way, none of these rules apply to naming your rival character. I recommend any names along the line of Cumgang or Dickelson. Anything like that.